The iOS 15 beta just dropped, and so did the Android 12 beta a few weeks ago. Now, with both Apple and Google borrowing more heavily from one another, I wanted to just take a moment and sit down and look at both OS's similarities and differences. I'm Luke Ponk with Android Authority, and let's see what company is doing the most borrowing. Now, our last video covered in depth all the new changes that Android 12 brought. So if you want more specific coverage, make sure to check out that video in the card above. Now today, there are far too many features and updates in both of these OSs to cover, so we're just going to cover the main attractions, so to speak. This year, Android 12 got a huge UI overhaul, whereas the update to iOS felt very iterative and more of a half update than anything else. That aside, the biggest change to iOS is the update to notifications. For years, notifications on Android have been, well, far better than iOS. But now iOS 15 groups notifications so that users are no longer bombarded. The notifications appear in stacks and are ordered using AI to figure out the priority. Messaging apps and frequently used apps should appear at the top. And users can also set up scheduled summaries and select which apps they would like to be notified from in those summaries and when they want them delivered. Android, on the other hand, has had a major change to the way notifications appear and how the lock screen looks in general. Comparing the two side by side, you can clearly see that Android 12 has a bigger and more simple focus on the clock, whereas the clock remains in the top portion of the screen on the iPhone. I will say it does appear that Apple is taking some notes from Android, as the new rounded notifications look similar to Android 12's notifications. Apple also released a feature called Focus, which lets you select which apps, home screens, and people are present when you are in a certain focus mode. Let's say I wanted to set myself as working. I can now select which people I want to contact me and which apps on certain home screens I want to see. Now when I'm working, this will minimize distractions and help me stay focused. This status also applies to other apps and messages and will tell other individuals when you're in a particular mode. Users can still force send a notification though if it's urgent, similar to how Slack handles this. Apple also did release an API to allow other third-party apps to make use of this focus or status feature. Android has had a similar focus feature for a while now, but it isn't as easily as accessible as it is in iOS. On Android 12, you have to create a work profile that will let you simulate what focus does on iOS, but unfortunately I couldn't get this to work, and on the beta on Android 12, the system app just kept crashing. Now, another big change to Android 12 was its UI. Google focused on design and announced a new system-wide change called Material U. Unfortunately, this won't be available for testing until later this year, but some of the changes have carried on over to the beta version. Turning to the home screen, it looks normal enough, but swiping down on the notification shade reveals a card instead of buttons or tiles. These cards can be customized to your liking. iOS 15, on the other hand, doesn't really change anything in its control center apart from the addition of the aforementioned focus button. Google's Material U redesign carries over to the settings where things have been changed from the ground up. Most settings remain in a similar position, but the design is simplified and a bit easier to navigate. Settings on iOS 15 look identical with only a few additions for different items such as a new focus tab and settings for FaceTime. And that brings me to one of the bigger updates with iOS 15, FaceTime. FaceTime received a major overhaul including a new grid mode, new options to create and send FaceTime links, and some updates to the microphone including noise isolation and a wide spectrum mode. Users who are not on an Apple device can now receive a link to where they can just join a call, but they cannot make the call themselves. In reality, this is kind of a huge update, and I never would have thought that Apple would open up something so closed as FaceTime to other devices, even if the Android phone render they showed in the keynote was incredibly insecure and a bit self-conscious. Now, Apple has always said that iMessage and I thought FaceTime would never come to Android, but maybe now there's a possibility. These updates come hot on the heels of the pandemic as working from home and talking with coworkers and friends over apps such as Zoom has become increasingly important. Google also updated their Meet app to do similar things, but that's outside the realm of Android 12 specifically. A feature that Android has implemented for quite some time now is Google Lens. This year, Android 12, Google Lens has been updated to give more accurate results using AI. Apple seems to have responded to this with an update of their own called Live Text. Live Text allows users to select from the camera and images, and I've got to be honest, it feels a bit more polished here in iOS 15 than in Android 12. And in most text fields, there's just an option to get text from camera. Yes, Google Lens already had this capability, and in the Pixel, it's pretty easy to swipe over to the rightmost home screen in the camera, but iOS 15's implementation is a little bit more straightforward overall. Both OSs saw a small update to Photos, and in Android 12, Google Photos now implements a feature called Cinematic Moments, which basically uses AI to interpolate images to create pseudo-animated photos. Unfortunately, this feature won't be available until later this year. iOS 15, on the other hand, gets an update to Memories and now has support for Apple Music integration and a bunch of other things such as filters. Again, both Android 12 and iOS 15 are getting pretty major updates to their respective maps. Apple Maps gets an updated UI and gets far more detailed information on streets and directions, and Google also updated its maps and gives you more detailed information about streets and crosswalks, as well as indoor live view. Both OSs provide a very similar experience across the board. Now, unfortunately, there were not any big UI changes to Google Chrome, but Safari received another overhaul. Now in iOS 15, the search bar has been relegated to the bottom to make it easier to navigate on bigger phones. There's also group tabs and a whole host of other minute changes. And that's pretty much it. It does seem like Android is currently leading when it comes to changes in software. While Apple's updates have been iterative this year, it still is taking a lot of notes from Android. iOS 15 now has group notifications, whereas Android has had this for years. iOS 15 now has a focus or a status mode, and Android has more or less had the same thing with a work profile. And iOS 15 finally gets live text, which is basically just Google Lens. The point is, Apple has taken quite a long time to introduce features that have really already existed on Android. Now, to be fair, both companies did talk about privacy in their keynotes, with Google driving home the secure by default mantra. They released a privacy dashboard literally moments ago that gives users a 24-hour report on what apps are using what. Apple in turn gave users more options in iOS 15 to see a 7-day average of what apps are using things like location and microphones, as well as providing more transparency as to what apps are using what. Funny enough, it looks like Google borrowed from Apple's implementation of clipboard notifications in iOS 14, because now in Android 12, it will give users a toast notification when an app accesses something from the clipboard data. Again, Google has implemented similar features in past versions of Android, and the Apps tab in Settings will give you information on what apps use what permissions, but it seems like Apple is trying to make these features a little bit more accessible and mainstream. Although Android may have had this first, I'm glad to see that Apple is taking some steps to make security a primary concern, as that's just going to be good for everyone and make other companies a bit more transparent as well. Apart from that though, Google really used Android 12 to focus on design and customization, something that Apple has really long neglected. The new updates to Material U provide a level of customization that we really haven't seen in quite some time. Still, Apple is doing what it's always done and taking small features that Android has already had and implementing them in a more polished and maybe more user-friendly way. Honestly, I would have preferred Apple to just add features a long time ago and then made them better over time, rather than waiting a really long time to release them in the first place. And I think it's this ideology that's the main difference between these two companies. Google's always hot on the trail of the latest and greatest in technology. Take, for example, Project Starlight. Google teased this new technology in the I/O keynote, which aims to create 3D video calls in real time. I mean, this is really cool stuff. But Apple, on the other hand, waits until the technology is developed, then tested, then waits some more to finally release a feature. Obviously, both companies are focused on privacy, but this feels more like a response to current world events than anything else, especially considering that Apple and Facebook are constantly going at it. All this to say, the new updates to both iOS 15 and Android 12 speak miles to where both companies stand. On the one hand, Google is pushing forward, focusing on personalization and user experience, whereas on the other hand, Apple is implementing small, highly optimized, and well-developed features that have already existed in Android. Well, that's going to wrap it up for this video. Make sure to comment down below what your favorite feature of either OS was, or what you just thought in general of both versions. Also, if you want more information about Android 12, check out our most recent video down below. I'm Luke Pogue with Android Authority, and I'll catch you in the next video.